बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। हाउ माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेड 7, आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू एन एक्टिविटी ऑफ कॉम्प्रिहेंशन। फॉर दिस पर्पस आई हैव सिलेक्टेड अ पैसेज, आई एम गोइंग टू रीड इट आउट। प्लीज नोट इट ऑन योर नोटबुक्स एंड लिसन टू इट केयरफुली। लेटर एट द एंड यू विल बी बाउंड टू आंसर द क्वेश्चंस। हियर वी गो विद आवर मेन पैसेज। With a widespread popularity of information technology, it has become easy for all the individuals to transmit their ideas, obtain knowledge, and do various types of businesses. Not very long ago, almost 2 decades ago, people were using conventional methods and techniques to meet their needs. Thanks to the massive growth of cyber facilities, the picture is now totally different what it looked 20 years ago. Nowadays, people have got ample opportunities to ease their lives by exploiting different features of the technologies. Travel, commerce, tourism, education, agriculture, and all other domains of everyday life are now directly or indirectly linked with the internet. According to the experts, some countries will literally launch paperless education forever in the coming years. Also, those countries are ready to introduce digital currency after eliminating traditional paper currency gradually. The construction of housing units in megacities will take days and not months for the completion. High-rise buildings will have absolute rotating aspects to adjust themselves in accordance with the wind direction and natural sunlight. Thermal and nuclear energies are going to be substituted with solar energy across the globe. These are some of the manifestations which we may witness sooner or later. So far we have concluded our passage. Now we are going to witness 2 main questions here. What kind of buildings will we have in the future? This is our question number 1. What kind of buildings will we have in the future? And question number 2. How has the information technology helped people? My dear students, when you are going to comprehend any passage, make sure that you are going to include the information available in that certain paragraph or paragraphs here. Adding any outside information will not give any bonus to you. So you have to restrict yourselves to the point here. Also, you cannot delete any important information. In accordance with the number of the mark and space available in the answer sheet, you have to sum up the answer in complete comprehensive sentences here. The answers in this kind of activity in the form of fragments will not be acceptable. So it's better you must try your answer in complete sentences. All the best wishes. See you next time with a new lesson. Till then, bye bye.